Welcome to Emboldened Movement. My name is Chelsea and I will be leading you in this sun and moon balancing flow today. So grab a mat, a block or two, and I'll meet you there. Two more. Inhale, rise. Exhale, release. Inhale, rise. Exhale, release. Inhale, arms come up. This time, interlacing the fingers. Point your fingers face up. Bring big toes together, a couple inches between the heels. Deep inhale in. Exhale, begin to bow towards the left side, really lengthening that right side of the body. Relax your head between your arms. Right hip should be tracking towards the right. Breathing nice and deep. For three. For two. Inhale, brings you back up. Wiggle out of those hips, really lengthening tall through the spine. Exhale off towards the right side this time. Left hip tracking out. Again, really relax the head between the arms. For three. For two. Inhale, takes you up. Exhale, hands to heart center. From here, just begin to do some shoulder rolls. Inhale, shoulders towards the ears. Exhale, down the back. Forward, coming up. Always coming back to the breath. And then reverse, coming up the back. Ground into the left foot. We're going to come into tree pose. So maybe you just keep your right toes on the mat, heel on the ankle, maybe bring that foot up towards the calf, or even up towards the inside of the thigh. Wherever you are, just avoid putting any pressure on the knee. We want to protect that joint as much as possible. So hands can either be at the heart, or you can extend the arms up for the extended tree variation. Wherever you are, relax those shoulders, down the back. Okay. Gaze can be in front of you here. Gaze nice and soft. Nice tall trees. For three. For two. Inhale. Release the foot. But bring that knee in towards the chest. So arms can still be extended here. And then exhale, bring right leg over to the right side, opening that hip. Good. Inhale, back to front, knee to front. Exhale, opening wide through the left, the right hip. Inhale, forward, one more time. Open that leg wide, and then just release right hand to the mat. Right foot rather to match, hands can turn center. Same thing on the opposite side, ground through the right foot, maybe your left toes come to the mat, maybe foot is to the calf, or maybe foot is up towards the right thigh. Again, hands to be at heart center, or maybe you take the extended variation. Gaze in front of you, soft gaze. Breathing nice and deep. Really filling that lower belly there with each inhale. And releasing as much as you can with each exhale. From here, release the foot, bring the knee forward, still bend. Let that left leg open, come around towards front, open that left hip, bring that knee forward, one more time. So lots of balance here, forward again, release hands to heart center. Shake out the legs, bending the knees if that feels good for you, flexing and pointing the toe to release the arch of the foot. Bouncing poses are so important to do. It does take a lot on the feet, especially if you're not used to them. Maybe give yourself some ankle rolls here. Not forgetting one side, the other. And then from here, coming in to just a couple rounds of some salutation. Inhale, arms come high. Exhale, fold forward. Pausing here for a moment, checking in with the feet, feet about hip distance apart. Slight bend in the knee, flat back, halfway lift. Exhale, fold down. Bending the knee, inhale, come up. Hands to heart center. Inhale, arms come high. Exhale, dive forward, leading with the chest. Flat back. Bending the knee, inhale, arms come up. Hands to heart center. Again, inhale, rise. Exhale, fold, leading with the heart. Flat back. Fold, bend those knees. Inhale, nice and high. Hands to heart center. Building on that sequence, inhale, arms come high. Exhale, fold forward. Flat back. Fold. Plant the hands, come down to the knees. From here, bring right leg out. You're still on your left knee. Right hand comes to the right leg. Inhale, allow the left arm to come up over and stretch towards the right side. We're coming into a variation of gate pose. The right foot is flat on the ground, gaze slightly up. Breathing nice and deep. For three. For two. Inhale, send the hips back, arm comes forward. Planting left hand down, inhale, right arm up, press those hips forward for circle. Breathing nice and deep. For three. For two. Inhale, circle right hand forward. Hands coming forward on the mat. Let that right foot come up, toes towards knee, and then just begin to fold forward, sitting back on the heel of the left foot. Relax the head, the neck, and the shoulders. Really allow yourself to sink into this pose, feeling the lengthening in the muscles of the legs. For three,
for two. Deep inhale in, exhale, walk those hands back towards center. Coming up on the left knee, switching sides.
So lengthening through the left leg this time, left hand on left leg, inhale right arm high, reaching over to the left side of the body. Gaze slightly up. Breathing nice and deep. Maybe experiment with bringing the sides of the mouth up towards the eyes. Deep inhale in, exhale.
Send that right hand forward, planting the right hand on the right side of the body. Left arm sweeps overhead, pressing left hips forward. Filling that belly with air, each inhale and exhale. Just notice where you feel any sensation, any lengthening. Deep inhale in, sweep left hand forward, sitting back on that right heel. Left toes come up towards the knee. Deep inhale in, walk the hands out as you fold the chest toward the knee. Let yourself sink deeper and deeper into this pose. Maybe your forehead comes to the mat. Deep inhale in, walk those hands towards the knee. Come back up on the right leg. Knees come underneath you. From here, walk the hands out, coming into puppy pose. Forehead comes to the mat, hips stay high. Breathing nice and deep, really lengthening through those front arms. Through the shoulders. Few more breaths here. Deep inhale in, exhale, allow yourself to come forward off the knees for a second. Lengthen through the legs. Now with the hands, really spread the fingers wide. We're in Sphinx pose. So relax shoulders away from ears. Really lengthen the spine nice and tall. Feel the grounding of the forearms into your mat. Breathing nice and deep for three. For two. Deep inhale in, exhale, just allow your chest to come towards the ground, releasing the forearms. This time bring the hands just a little bit ahead of your shoulders, maybe 6 inches or so, maybe a little bit wider than your shoulders. Deep inhale in, allow your chest to draw the shape of a C up towards your expression of cobra pose. This is the first expression of cobra pose. So again, really lengthening through the back legs, planting hands, kind of pressing through the hands just a little bit here. Lifting the heart, keeping the shoulders nice and open. For three, for two, deep inhale in, exhale, release.
We're gonna come into that pose one more time.
This time, see if you can just use your fingertips as you come up.
So not so much pressing through the palms, but more through the fingertips. So deep inhale in, again, drawing that shape of a C as you come up, coming up onto the fingertips,
really relaxing those shoulders. It's just getting a little bit deeper into this back bend.
Breathing nice and deep
Slight tuck of the chin for three. For two. Deep inhale in, exhale, release. Bring those hands right under the shoulders, pressing yourself back to child's pose just for a moment here. Now from here, coming back onto hands and knees. Lengthen the body up. We're gonna come into camel pose. So this, I don't want you to go too deep into this pose today. So really just take a mild version. So making fists, just plant them on the lower back. Lengthen up through the spine, nice and tall. Relax the shoulders away from the ears. Deep inhale in. And exhale, just begin to slowly lean back. Gaze going up, maybe the throat opens. Pressing hips forward. Inhale takes you back up. We're gonna do that two more times, okay? Just light back bends. Lengthen through the spine, nice and tall. Deep inhale in. Exhale, hips push forward. Maybe throat opens. Inhale, takes you back up. Now this time, same thing. Pressing those hips forward. Allowing your body to create that curve open to the throat. Then if it feels good, maybe bring your hands down towards your heels. Getting a little bit deeper into the expression. Now you don't have to do that, so you can do exactly what we were doing before. But if you want to experiment and record your body, that's an option. Deep inhale in, bringing those hands behind the back. Slowly rise on up. Take a moment, maybe do a couple circles in the shoulders in one direction and then the other. When you're ready, plant right hand down, extend left leg out, left arm goes up. So for some, we're coming into a kneeling half moon pose here. So maybe you stay here, or maybe you lengthen through that left leg, flexing those toes. Wherever you are, just pause and breathe right here. Focusing in on the breath. Just noticing your body in space. Deep inhale in, release left foot. Walk the hands out in front of you. Switching sides, coming onto the left knee, extending through that right leg. Left hand comes to the left side of the body, inhale, right arm high. And then if it feels good to you, lifting that back leg, flexing those toes. Breathing nice and deep here. You might feel this, a little bit in the abs, a little bit in the upper thighs, the hip flexors. Backs of the legs. Breathing nice and deep. For three. For two. Inhale, come forward. Releasing that right leg. Come up on the toes now. Sit those heels, or sit the butt back, and then lengthen through the arms. Coming into a form of child's pose with hero toes.
From here, keeping the hands just where they are, begin to lengthen through the legs, coming into downward facing dog. Really pressing equally through the feet, through the hands, specifically the knuckles. Let your head go from side to side here, really allowing for some additional opening in the neck. And then as you're ready, just begin to walk the hands a couple inches at a time towards the toes. Coming into a forward fold. Inhale to flat back. Exhale down, forward fold, bending the knees. Inhale, come all the way up. Hands to heart center. Inhale, arms come up. Exhale, dive forward, lean with the chest. Flat back. Fold. This time, plant the hands, walking yourself out to downward facing dog. Making any adjustments you need here. Inhale, right leg comes up high, keeping those hips in alignment. Exhale, bring that knee underneath, curling up through the upper back, knee to nose. Extend back, three-legged dog. Inhale, crunching underneath you, knee to nose, really rounding through those shoulders. Exhale back. Three more here, curling up, knee to nose. Exhale back. Inhale forward, knee to nose. Exhale back, inhale forward, knee to nose. This time, bringing right foot down, dropping left knee, inhale, arms come up, front asana. Breathe nice and deeply here, relax shoulders away from ears, tuck the tailbone under. Deep inhale in, begin to twist over towards the right leg. Maybe bring left elbow to right knee. Gaze coming towards the right elbow. A little bit of balance here. For three, for two. Deep inhale in, curl back toes, extend through the back leg. Still in that twist here. Nice and strong. Now, this may feel good for you and you're more than welcome to stay here. Or we're going to take some toe taps, or knee taps rather. Deep inhale in, exhale, tap the knee, extend through the leg. Inhale, tap, exhale, extend. Three more. Tap. Extend, tap, extend, last one. Inhale, come back to center. Hands come down, chin mat, extend through front leg. You may want to bring back foot forward just a couple inches as we come into pyramid pose. So, hands may be on the mat, they may be on your leg. Just take whatever feels comfortable and stable for you. We're going to need a lot of balance work. Maybe sway from side to side, just gently here. And then as you're ready, begin to turn right foot so the toes are kind of in a perpendicular stance. So we're coming into warrior two stance. So make any adjustments you need here. Nice bend in that front right leg. Arms to the sides of the body. We're gonna be here just for a couple of breaths. Really opening through that right hip. Inhale, reverse the warrior. Still keep that bend in the front leg. Exhale, back to center. lengthening through front leg. We're going to set up for triangle pose. So deep inhale in, draw left hip back, extend right hand forward, and then just let that hand come towards the shin. So you really want to make yourself as flat as you can in this position. 3, for 2. So from here, bend forward in that knee, bring right hand forward. So we're coming into half moon, standing half moon. We've done half moon in a kneeling position, so this is just a little bit different of a variation. So same rules apply, it's a balanced pose. So make sure that you keep your back feet flexed. The top arm pointing towards the sky. And it might be helpful here, and I wish I had one, a block under the bottom hand. A couple more breaths here. I'll show you the block on the next side. Deep inhale in, exhale, bend at that right knee, coming back to warrior two. Inhale, hands come forward, coming onto the back toes. Plant the hands, right foot goes back. Find your right downward facing dog. Feel free to bend one knee and then the other here if that feels good to you. And then just as we did on the opposite side, inhale, left leg up. You're in three-legged dog, keep those hips square. Deep inhale in, bring that knee underneath you, crunching, rounding through the upper back. Exhale back. Inhale, crunch. Exhale, back. Inhale, come forward. Back. Two more here. Last one. Plant the hand. Drop your right knee. Inhale, curl back toes under. Lengthen through back leg. Now we're going to do those knee touches, knee taps in a moment. Just take a couple breaths here to get yourself feeling steady. If you feel really wobbly, feel free to bring that back leg a little bit more distant from the body, from the center. Deep inhale in. Tap the knee, extend. Inhale, tap. Exhale, extend. Three more. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Last one. Good. Plant the hands. Lengthen through the front leg. Back foot comes forward. We're in pyramid pose. So really keeping those hips nice and square here. Just allow yourself to sway from side to side. Good.
All right, bending front leg. Bring back leg towards warrior two stance. So I'm gonna turn around for you this time so you can see it from the front. Okay. Couple breaths here, tucking that shoulder under. Being mindful that your torso is right underneath the hips. Inhale, reverse forward. Exhale back to warrior two. Lengthening through that front leg. Pop that right hip back. Extend forward. Left hand coming to the inside of the left shin. Breathe nice and deep here, gazing in front of you. Up at the thumb of your right hand. Whatever feels good, whatever feels stable for you in your body today. Deep inhale in, take a bend in that front knee. Coming back to warrior two. Grab your block if you have it. We're going to come into half moon analysis of it. So deep inhale in, come forward. Placing your hand on the block. Lifting that back leg, flexing the toes toward the knee. So you can play with how tall you want your block to be. Pause and breathe here. Allow yourself to be eased into this balance pose. Really creating balance with as much as you're pressing down into the ground or your block. You're equally pressing and reaching up towards the sky above you. You're pressing the crown of the head, whatever is in front of you, just as much as you're pressing that back foot towards the wall on the opposite end of you. A few more breaths here. Deep inhale in, bend front knee, coming into a goddess squat. So you might have to modify your feet here a little bit, bringing a little bit more length, toes are pointing away from the body. Hands to heart center for a moment. And then just bring palms towards the knees. Bringing one shoulder forward, getting a little bit deeper into the stretch. Inhale back to center. Opposite shoulder goes forward. One more time each side. Inhale center. Hands come to the mat, heel, toe, feet together, and then coming into a malasana squat, just allow the sit bones to come behind you, hands coming to your heart. Pausing here for a moment, just noticing the body, noticing all the stretch and the space that you created. Deep inhale in, exhale, release, make your way to a seated position. Lengthening the legs out, allowing yourself to come onto your mat. Inhale, you're breathing into the chest here, to a little squeeze. Deep inhale in, let that right knee come over the left side of the body. Coming into a twist, extending right arm, gaze over the right arm.
As you're ready, let that left knee go over the right side of the body, extending the left arm. Gaze over the left hand. Eyes can be open or closed here. Notice what it feels like. And you take a deep inhale in, holding it there, and then exhale nice and slow through the nose. Holding the breath out, and then inhale again. Holding at the top. Pausing for a moment, giving yourself gratitude for being in this space, for allowing yourself to come on your mat today.